Blood involvement in cutaneous T-cell lymphoma can occur even at early stages of mycosis fungoides, and by definition in Sézary syndrome. In this video series, I will discuss hypothetical example patient cases where flow cytometry was ordered to assess blood involvement. These examples may be similar to patients you see in your practice. Let's discuss patient 2 to find out why flow cytometry was ordered. Patient 2 is a 40-year-old woman. She was initially diagnosed 2 years ago with a stage 1B mycosis fungoides. Skin was the only involved compartment, classified as T2, involving approximately 12% of body skin surface. She had no lymphadenopathy, and flow cytometry utilizing a T-cell panel showed no evidence of blood involvement at diagnosis. Furthermore, there was no evidence of extracutaneous involvement by imaging. Patient 2 was treated with phototherapy and bexarotin, and her skin symptoms were well controlled for around 1 year. Currently, she's presenting with worsening skin symptoms, including an increasing extent of patches and plaques, now covering over 25% of body surface area. She has also recently developed multiple skin tumors, suggestive of disease progression. Let's go over her workup and clinical findings. A complete blood cell count showed normal white blood cell distribution without lymphocytosis. Palpation showed enlarged axillary lymph nodes. PET CT imaging revealed enlarged lymph nodes ranging from 2 to 3 centimeters with increased SUV uptake. Lymph node biopsies revealed dermatopathic changes with small clusters of abnormal medium-sized lymphocytes. All of these are indicative of disease progression. At this point, I would choose to perform new skin biopsies because of the abnormal lymph node findings along with the presence of new tumor lesions. Skin biopsy of a tumor lesion showed a diffuse infiltrate composed of large cells, indicative of large cell transformation. Here, the large cells can be clearly seen in this high-power image. Now, before we move on, what clinical flags would lead me to suspect blood involvement and prompt a flow cytometry test? In this case, clinical flags that raised my suspicion of disease progression included worsening skin symptoms with increased extent of affected skin, changes in lesion type from plaque to tumor, and evidence of large cell transformation on skin biopsy indicating disease acceleration. Lymphadenopathy was also observed, suggestive of early extracutaneous disease. In this patient, to me, these are all indicative of disease progression and prompted further investigation, including a biopsy of new skin tumors, lymph node biopsy, imaging, and repeat flow cytometry test. In this patient's case, a blood sample was taken for flow cytometry. The blood sample, together with the skin biopsies, were sent to the same lab to test for clonality and to evaluate whether there may be matching T-cell clones in the blood and skin. Flow cytometry showed a normal absolute lymphocyte count with a slight increase in the CD4 to CD8 ratio of 5. The pathologist reported an abnormal discrete clone of CD4 positive, CD7 negative, CD26 negative abnormal cells, accounting for 29% of total lymphocytes, or an absolute count of 850 cells per microliter. This represents a B1 classification bordering on B2. Clonality was also confirmed by performing T-cell gene rearrangement analysis of the skin and blood, demonstrating the same clonal signature at both sites. For consistency, I would send the blood sample to the same flow cytometry lab that made the initial diagnosis to minimize variability due to differing methodologies and antibody panels across centers. Because this patient progressed to a higher stage, in my experience, it's important that she continue to be routinely monitored with flow cytometry to check for further signs of progression. In closing, keep in mind these clinical considerations and recommendations related to this patient's case. One in three patients with mycosis fungoides progress to later stage disease, which can affect skin, lymph nodes, blood, or other systemic compartments. Patients with abnormal flow and abnormal clones must be closely followed because they may indicate evolving Sézary syndrome. Per NCCN guidelines, patients with disease progression ideally should be managed by a multidisciplinary team, including oncologists, dermatologists, and pathologists with CTCL expertise. Thank you for watching. I hope this information is useful. For more information, including additional patient cases, explore probeincTCL.com.